Welcome, guys. So this episode of Painting with Amber turned out to be two canvases, but enough paint to create a third one. I used four basic colors. I used pink, yellow, turquoise, and purple, layering the cups with the colors of my choosing. If you're at home watching, give me a like, subscribe, and share if you wish. Just remember, I started painting because I saw a YouTube video and said, I want to do that. Remember that. It all starts from watching a YouTube video. So I'm using one part acrylic, two parts Floetrol. If you're allergic to latex, do not use Floetrol. You can substitute with water. So welcome to my paint room. Gotta have the music. I don't know if you guys can see me, but I don't care right now. I just want to make sure that you can see the pour. I like my music, but sometimes it's too loud. So welcome. I'm so excited to see how these come out. So again, I mixed the colors, the one part acrylic, two parts Floetrol. There we go. So the object is to pour this paint onto the canvas and then tilt. So let's see. I have a lot of paint. You can do zigzags or whatever you want. One. I go ahead and pour them all on there, and then you work one at a time if you want. You can do it however you wish. I try to keep them similar pours just because I'm doing them as a pair or a set. In this case, I'm doing three. I mixed up the color patterns just a little bit. These are so beautiful. And the third one. Rainbow colors. You never know. How are you guys doing out there? If you find this video, I would love it if you would comment below where you're from or how you even found this video. I'm still tripping out at my other video of me doing this in my living room, and it's got over 17,000 views. Another one over 1,000. So it's obvious to me that during COVID especially, I got more into this again. I started painting back in 2018, I'd say the end of 2018, beginning of 2019, watching YouTube videos. It took me a while to figure out how to mix the paints and what to use and where to save money, but I'll tell you what, it's worth it in the end. So, I put a little bit of silicone in one color. It's a couple drops, so we'll see. Take our time. Just don't like to waste a ton of paint if I can help it. As it takes its time, the cells will stay. If you can see a lot of the cells coming out, so beautiful. You can always go back and get the corners. Tell you what, everyone I've had do a canvas came back and wanted to do another one. They loved it. I like to believe that our souls come out in these canvases. How we're feeling, our visions, even stuff we don't even realize we have. Opens up our minds to our creative spark. Showing our uniqueness and our individuality on top of healing. You know, when I was out doing landscaping, people would always ask me how I always got my strength for it. And I said, you know, it's all in how you look at it. If you get overwhelmed, yeah, you're going to get discouraged. You make mistakes. But if you look at it as something fun, something healing in it, on top of what you're doing for someone else, it makes it all the more fun. I really believe that. Let's get some of these corners there, you know. Hey, look, we had enough paint. Yeah. Now, when I did the landscaping, as I was saying, it was my anger management. It was my reason to get out everything I wanted. I got tired of fighting myself, so started taking it out in the landscaping. And turn it around again. Ah, this is beautiful. Let's pull it down a little bit. Four colors. Awesome. I can't help it. I have to keep saying it. It's awesome. The whole object is to think, not just do. Don't think. All right. Let's see how this one goes. I'm sure you guys can see all of this. You know, I talked about the lighting and stuff in my place before, but it's not that bad. Believe me, if I had the money to be able to expand, you know, my audio and my videos, I would, but we make do with what we have, that's for sure. It's It's moving a little fast because it's really thick in the center. Next time you can add a little bit of water to it to thin it out a little bit if you want. Forgive me, my hair is getting in my face a little bit. Thank you guys for watching. Thank you for liking and subscribing and sharing to my randomness. My videos, whether I'm cooking, dancing in my house, listening to my friends play music, music at the park. I'm just very grateful and humble to know that you guys are all enjoying the show, you know? When I do my videos, there is no real intention behind it except for expressing and trying to show you how I'm feeling. I try to draw you into what you're watching, you know? Give you the same kind of passion that I get from it. Isn't that beautiful? Wow. Totally different than the other one. I'm seeing somewhat of a, like a bridge. Using my plastic, but you know what? I gotta buy more. There we go. I think I got it. Beautiful. Oh, that one's ready to go already. Look at it. It's like, I'm leaving. I hope you guys can still see it. This one's ready to go. What I really would like to invest in someday is a spinner. One that I could put the canvas on and just spin it, but you definitely need a lot of plastic coverage for that. I really do. I want to just charge it. I'm gonna go ahead and let this one fall quick, just because I can. Don't trust what the process is, you just gotta trust yourself. Beautiful things happen. I do have a lot of paint on them though, that's why it's so heavy. Wow. This one kind of reminds me of the feathers on them. What are those birds? I always forget what they're called. Ones with the beautiful big feathers, they show them off. I'm sure you guys can tell me in the comments below. All right. Let's see here. I have made the mistake of dropping this on its face. Like literally. It went splat right on the plastic. And the funny thing is after that happened, I was all sad because it was a good painting. But when it dried, it was worth it. The beautiful images that came out after that was how I started detailing my canvases. first few times I detailed what I saw in the images, you know, it turned out to take a couple weeks, you know, to detail. But you realize how creative you can be with your imagination. This one's cool, man. There's all kinds of like seashells and wow. Let me see if I can move the paint a little bit more. Look at that. What do you guys think? Pretty cool if you ask me. This one's done. Maybe. I'm gonna tilt it a little bit more that way. Look at all that. Can you guys see it? I really hope you can. It's beautiful. I'll just leave it. Well, there you go, guys. Three cups, three canvases. What, 10-15 minutes? It's addicting. Be careful if you start doing this at home. I'm telling you, you're gonna want to do, I've done up to 8 canvases in just one sitting. I got so excited I either ran out of paint or canvases. If you guys would like to see more of this, please let me know in the comments below. And if you have time to set aside and join me, you know, while I do my project, you do your project at home. Hey, I'm down with that. That is probably the best thing we can do. Support each other online. Here, let me see if I can zoom in. Oop, I'm getting paint all over. All right, here we go. Cool. Funky town. This is like going to a funky town, isn't it? Wow. Look at this. If you like what you see and you enjoy it and want more of it, hit the like button. If you'd like to donate to my channel, I will leave the link below and you can donate if you wish. Of course, as you know, the weeks and months go by, times are getting harder and a lot of people are actually going online, and considering I love what I'm doing, it's always advisable to ask for whatever you can when you need it. No matter what, I'm going to keep painting and flourishing and creating and giving back. So have a beautiful and blessed day.